Thank you, Chair. Dear colleagues, I'm very satisfied to reach this successful outcome of the Connecting Europe facility. After a year and a half of hard work and good cooperation with my two fellow co-rapporteurs for transport, Mrs. Alassander and Mr. Riquet, whom I warmly thank for the constructive approach that we achieved in this complex dossier. Tomorrow we will vote on this new European instrument that will dedicate €33 billion worth of investment to improve Europe's transport, energy and telecommunication networks. This new funding instrument is potentially a real revolution and at least a shift of paradigm. It is the only growth policy in the EU budget for the 7 years to come. In time of crisis, we are obliged to be creative, to respond with limited means to the challenges we are facing. With the CEF, public money will be spent in the most efficient way by maximizing the use of innovative financial instruments. These instruments have the capacity to create a leverage effect by attracting private funding that is available on the world capital market. In doing so, it can multiply up to 15-20 times the initial budget. So the CEF, we are sending a positive message to world investors, telling them that Europe is still an attractive and innovative capital market. It is even more important to invest in our infrastructures, that they are at the primary growth generator in all sectors of the economy. However, they are on the verge of becoming outdated and are insufficiently interconnected. As a consequence, there is a real risk of market fragmentation and renationalization of policies in the fields of energy, transport and telecommunications if the current state of play is maintained. When we know that our needs to upgrade and interconnect our infrastructure amount to €1.5 trillion, we have no choice but siding with the private sector to leverage massive financial means. The CEF is also a shift in mentality, as it focuses on financing projects that only have European added value. This makes us envisage the common good for Europe and drift away from the traditional nationalist behavior of 28 member states, each fighting to get its financial envelope. With a total budget of €33 billion, it is still necessary to decide what political priorities are to be financed. That is what the Parliament heavily discussed with the Council, and I am satisfied that we agreed on broad terms that, with €5.8 billion, the European Union will make substantial improvements to complete the internal energy market, interconnect our member states and regional submarkets, and ensure our security of supply. A number of European projects of common interest have already been identified and will be granted priority for permits and funding. For countries in Eastern Europe, it is a much-awaited response to the investment needs. If I take Romania as an example, projects like White Stream will allow better interconnection and integration within the European energy market. As a key growth factor, the digital economy and the telecom sector will benefit from €1.1 billion to support investment in pan-European digital service. This should allow large deployment of online and cross-border services of public interest to benefit of European citizens and businesses. In today's world, it is crucial for Europe to create an environment defined by competitiveness and smart growth, as well as make the EU market attractive to world investors again. I am convinced that the Connecting Europe facility is, before anything else, the right tool which can boost our competition and create the basis for growth. Thank you.